sample will be analyzed. And it requires 3 minutes, as small as 3 minutes for 12 sample. And it can go up to 18 minutes, depends on the method you are choosing. If it is a 3 minutes per row, 12 samples, right? It's 12 into 8, 96, right? So 3 into 8, within 30 minutes, 96 sample gel electrophoresis is over. Look at the fast. We set up a midi gel or a maxi gel, right? And then you run 12 sample, the 13th well anyway given for the size marker, right? The ladder. So you can do 12 sample. And for that, it will take 30 minutes, right? Apparently, when you do 8 lanes, 8 into 12, 96 sample, you use the gel 3 times. Assume you use the gel 3 times, still you need 3 gels, isn't it? To complete the 96 sample. In my case, it's just one cartridge, you just need to thaw it. And then take the cartridge and put it to the machine, run it, 3 minutes, 12 sample, done. Alright, so instrument is very fast and it uses a ready to run gel cartridge. The cartridge you will see in the next slide. It can do up to 96 sample without any human intervention, that's what I was mentioning. And the sample requirement is 0.1 microliter or below. Depends on the method and the concentration of your PCA product. The instrument requires just 0.1 microliter or less. At times it will take 0.3 if you say it is a low concentrated PCR product. When you say it is low, then it will take 0.3 microliter. Otherwise it's just 0.1 microliter. And the sensitivity of the system, the detection limit of the system is 0.1 nanogram per microliter. The one which you don't see in a normal naked eye, those things can be clearly visible here. The instrument will pick up those primer dimers you have, the broken piece of primer which comes and make up its own size. Everything will come into the play. So you can actually refine your entire PCR again based on the system's output. Alright. High resolution is the best part of our system with the high resolution cartridge, of course. The system can resolve 3 to 5 base pair bands. Say you have product A which is 92 base pair and product B which is 95 base pair. You can see them as two individual bands. So that is the kind of resolution we are talking about. For that you need to actually go for polyacrylamide, right? So here it's just one step, right? And then the data output is digital, so you don't have to have a gel dump system. When this system is there in the lab, you don't have to have an electrophoresis unit, no power pack is required, no gel documentation systems, right? You don't have to maintain these three systems, and you don't have to have agarose keep casting the gel, right? Keep casting 2% agarose gel or 1% agarose gel or 1%. No need to. And you don't have to prepare bottles and bottles of buffer. And importantly, you don't have to handle ethidium bromide, which we currently are doing, right? You don't have to handle ethidium bromide. And no need of a gel dock system. Gel dock system in the market itself is 10 lakh rupees from a bio brand, right? If you go for a good company gel dock, it's easily 10 lakh rupees. What is that we are talking about? We are talking about almost similar to the price point what we are talking about in a gel dock system. I'm giving you an automated gel dock system with electrophoresis in it, almost in the same price of a gel dock system. Simple, right? You don't have to use ethidium bromide. Apparently, it is good for you. Also, it is not environmental hazards, right? So, eco-friendly. So, this is the cartridge we are talking about. How this cartridge looks? It's actually a 12 capillary cartridge. If you look at this, is a stand. The gray color is a stand, and we have two 12 individual capillaries. So, this is actually a cartoon of the capillary. One among those 12 capillaries, right? If you look at, there is an LED light source in the bottom which actually illuminates your sample or the entire capillary basically, and your sample runs towards the positive charge, right? So when it crosses the detector signals will be amplified in photomultiple altitude and it will go to the screen gel software which is apparently going to show you the analog signals as digital signals, and you will be getting gel dock image as well as electrophorograph. If you look at, this is a gel dock. Actually, your vertical image has been put as a horizontal just to connect with your electrophorogram. Yeah. So this is the principle. If you look at the cartoon, we just break open the cartridge and to show you schematically how the system works. 12 capillaries taken sample and the sample actually passed through here. Alright, so there is actually a photomultiplier tube. You have 12 individual ports where the signals will be coming out when the product passed by. And those signals will be transmitted to the photomultiplier tube. This photomultiplier tube will convert the signals to peaks. Simple. So there are four different types of cartridges available with Qiagen for Qiagen Advanced. High resolution, DNA screening, fast analysis, RNA quality control. Almost all the four cartridges cost the same. Yeah. all the four cartridges cost the same. But if you look at the cost, look at the number of runs. First cartridge can do 1200 samples, and second can do 2400 samples, and the third can do 3000 samples. Depends on the number of samples, the percentage of polymer which we have it in the reservoir will differ, right? So the 3000 run sample can be used to resolve 50 base pairs or above. So percentage of your gel reduces, automatically the resolution capability also directly proportional reduces, right? So when you have a high resolution cartridge, the thickest possible gel, you get 3 to 5 base pair resolved, two bands, right? So that is the best thing about this cartridge. So you will choose the right cartridge for your experiments. Say for example, I am working on parental screening of a particular plant sample, P1, P2, right? And your progenies are there. And you need to look which one is P1 and which one is P2, correct? That case, first cartridge will go into the play. And you are looking for a normal gel. My product is amplified or not? Qualitative, positive, negative, correct? PCR worked or not? Band is there or not, correct? You go for DNA fast analysis cartridge, 3000 samples. So when you look at the first sample, the first cartridge, the cost per sample is somewhere around 70 rupees, 1200 sample. When it comes to the 3000 sample, the cost per sample is roughly 22 rupees. When you cast a normal agarose gel, the cost you are spending for a gel per sample is 17 rupees. What is the difference? Just 5 rupees. If you do 1000 sample, the cost you will actually add up is extra 5000 rupees. But the entire thing is automated, no gel dock, no ethylene bromide, no casting of gel. Everything is being taken care of by one little cartridge. That's it. So this the last one is actually to substitute your normal gel, normal slab gel. The first one is for higher experiments. Not just on P1, P2 screenings, right? Not only for you to do scoring. Right? You can use the high resolution cartridge for doing data, means NGS library screening. So we do NGS. If at all you are sending sample for NGS, you can do the library here and then you can just outsource the screening. Means the sequencing. Right? So in that case, you complete your library preparation. Before sending the library, you need to do QC. Everything is added on your bill. Say for example, you are giving just DNA. You ask the service provider to do everything. So he'll send the PCR, he'll do the library prep, he'll do the library QC, and then he'll do the sequencing, and then he'll do the data analysis. Now, you can do all these three things by yourself. Because the library QC instrument is there in your lab. You can check whether your library is 350 base pair plus or minus 5. And am I getting in a proper shape, the bell shape of my library. You can check in the same system. The system is equipped that way. And the same goes to RNA. If you're sending RNA for sequencing, RNA-seq, right? You need to do ring number. Correct? People will do ring number for RNA-seq. So when you do RNA-seq, your ring number, it should be more than 7. RNA integrity number. In our case, it's called RIS. RIN is patented by Agilent, so we cannot call RIN. So we call it RIS. It's RNA integrity score, and the same cutoff. Anything above 7, your RNA is good and intact, you can send it for sequencing. Simple. And the very same system will transform towards some high-end application system. And when it comes to the normal day-to-day application, you can just take a fast analysis cartridge. Just go ahead with your regular gel documentations. Alright? So this system can be used for high-end application as well a low-end application with a very nominal cost. And the same thing if you compare with any other fragment analyzer in the market, let it be Agilent, let it be Shimadzu, let it be ATG, they cannot give you this variety of consumables with a variety of applications. Especially when it comes to an educational institute, people are getting trained here on molecular biology aspects. When they step out of the university, they need to have these things on their resume, right? So when you use more of these technologies, it fetches you a better platform when you go and scope out for your postdoc or you look for a job. Right. So that way, these instruments add value to you. And if we have a multiple combination of alignment and size marker, which is a little early, I just skip this and get into the details later. How the system is working? Just need to get the cartridge, thaw it in the room temperature for 40 minutes, take the cartridge, put inside the machine. So the nitrogen cylinder we are showing here, it is actually for US and European market. For India, we don't have it. Instead, we use an external nitrogen cylinder. So we have a QIAxcel system, and then we have a laptop. A nitrogen cylinder should be purchased separately. The nitrogen cylinder will not cost you more than 50,000 rupees. And the refilling of the nitrogen cylinder requires only after 6 to 8 months. Depends on your usage. And each refilling costs you 2,000 rupees. But if you go with this nitrogen cylinder, small cylinders, per time you replace, it's 55,000 rupees. Way too expensive, never works for Indian economy. Also, it's not available in India by default. Because importing nitrogen cylinder is way too expensive for everyone. Alright. And then you just load in your sample, load sample, buffer and markers, select the respective protocol, say start run. That's it. The moment the run is started, you don't have to be around. The machine will take time left after 40 minutes. You don't have to be around. Entire 96 sample will be punched one after the other, one after the other, one after the other, and the data will be ready for you. When you go back, the data is all set. You just need to do one step analysis, just select the respective analysis profile, say start. Analysis will happen in like 90 seconds. Your data are ready. You get your size predicted, concentration predicted for each of yourself. And if at all you're working on a peak calling option, say I'm working on 5 different pathogens. Like a little detour from the routine discussion. I'm working on 5 different pathogens. I have 1000 samples. I need to know whether all the 5 pathogens are there in all the 1000 samples. Or what are the pathogens are there in the 1000 samples, okay? So I'm just loading all the 1000 samples. 100, 100, 100, 100, like 10 times, okay? There is an option called peak call. PK stands for pathogen A. PP is for pathogen B. I'll call those peaks. Then I'll run. Once the analysis is over, the machine will say, well A1 has pathogen A and B. Well 2 has pathogen C and D. You know, it picks the peak. And it calls for those peaks, it's called peak calling. So your report comes handy and you just need to track it which sample has what pathogen in no time, right? And your exporting and importing is so much comfortable and flexible. You can export your data to Excel format and you can import your data also to the software on an Excel format, right? Okay, so this is about a training slide, so I'm just trying to skip this. These are all the methods available, one can choose. So we have about 1200 second resolution. If you are working on RFLP, AFLP, right? If you want to just stretch, tease the products for a longer time, you can choose the longest method. We have OH, means we have 1400 and 1800 also. Right? So it's number of seconds it's actually resolved. The cartridge is the same, the capillary is the same, but you can just resolve it for 300 seconds or you can resolve it for 1700 seconds. Just by changing the method, right? So you can actually resolve things better, right? So this is something which is little too much for anybody to imagine. Yeah, the capillary size is the same, but still how can I resolve the same for 1200 seconds and it can be resolved in 300 seconds, right? This you will see when the machine is running. Okay, so we have a cartridge which needs to be calibrated before you start. Any cartridge you buy brand new, just need to do calibration once. That's called intensity calibration. We supply you the marker with the cartridge itself. Just run the cartridge with the respective marker and then the brand thickness will be uniformly maintained over all the 12 wells, means all the 12 capillaries. So everything will maintain a uniform thickness and the intensity of the particular product is being calibrated in all the 12 capillaries. So there is no difference between capillary to capillary. The variation between capillary to capillary is being nullified. It is kind of bringing everything to the same pitch. Intensity calibration, the very first thing. And then you will be using an alignment marker. The second thing is called alignment marker. Each capillary is individual electrophoresis unit basically. So one will run a little faster, one will run a little slower. When you come to a when you come to a size prediction, you'll be running your ladder along, right? So if everything is going up and down, you cannot compare the sizes apparently, isn't it? So you need to bring them all to the same page. So we use an alignment marker. See here, it's all up and down. This is my alignment marker. It's all up and down, right? So in this case, what happens? My sample, both are actually same. Just because the variation between this and that, it shows this is bigger than this, correct? Isn't it? So what I will do is, I'll use the alignment marker to set the ground straight, and then these guys will automatically fall in place. So we align them. This is very, very simple because it is taken into the level people started with their BSc. You will understand the concept of electrophoresis. They are not so hi-fi in terms of software, in terms of handling the instrument. It's pretty straightforward and easy. Toy your cartridge, put the machine in, means the cartridge inside the machine. You're done. And leave your sample, choose the right method. Open the cylinder, run the sample, get your data. That's it. So with a very minimum training, properly trained BSc with the technical course, BSMLT or BMLT, can able to handle the system within a week, completely by themselves. With MSCs, 1 day. For MSc students, 1 day. PhD students, they should not say any excuses. Half a day they should be in a position to handle the system. Yeah? Alright. Okay, so this is how the result will be. So the data looks pretty easy. It doesn't mean that we'll run off in the half a day, okay? Sorry. So the training will be for 2 days. First day, calibration, instrument handling, how to set markers, how to run size marker. Second day will be with your sample so the data analysis can be thoroughly checked. Okay? Just for the record. Alright, let's get back to the presentation. Results and data views. As I said, it's digital data output. This is actually an entire 96 well plate run. If you look at, entire 96 well plate is being run. Right? A1 to H1 actually. So it's 4 and 7. So one more is missing. H is missing. Technically, you can do all the 96. I'll show you the data. So you just need to drag and drop. I'll show you a couple of data here live so that you will understand how the system works. So this is a gel image. That's a gel doc image. And the very same gel doc image you can see as an electrophorogram, individual capillaries. So the moment I select this capillary, say for example, and that capillary's gel is here. And the respective electrophorogram is just kept above it. So that you are not deviating, right? So you are seeing the gel image. With respect to the gel image, you are seeing your electrophorogram, alright? And then we can do an electrophorogram overlay, one or the other. If you are looking for a genotype and you find one particular plant is giving you an additional peak, which is very important comparing to my wild types, and you call that as a new subtype or a variety, yes, you can put them and then show these two peaks additionally. So this one is my regular peak, but this is a new one. Graphically representing your data for your presentation and paper presentation, right? Okay, coming to the report. So report is, okay, this is pretty much for a user to design how my report should be. I can have the report for 96 samples in 3 pages, and the very same report can be dragged for 135 pages. Depends on the way you want, because the machine is going to keep throwing on data on you. Height, area of the peak, one on the other, you know, everything, because one data point will have 3 supporting documents, and each will have its own electrophorogram image, its own gel image, its own overlay image, and its own small snapshot image. Every single thing will come. You need to choose which one you need actually. It will calculate the concentration, it will calculate the size. It's just a prediction, of course. It won't be accurate, it will be near to accurate. That's fact for any real time, any fragment analyzer for the matter. So you will get a rough estimate of your product size as well your product concentration. Right? Okay, I'll show you the data, you will understand what it is. So this is a typical example how a run will look. Post run, this is exactly how your data look. This is your gel image. Alright, so then you will get your electrophorogram of your gel image. So this is one among the gel. So these two peaks, with the green plus, is my alignment marker, basically which aligns everything. And these two guys with the red plus is actually my target, my sample. It's a duplex. So you see it's 236 base pair and it is 526 base pair. Size is just a prediction. It may be 532 also, as per your in silico, but it just predicts. When it comes to the concentration here, it tells you, see it's 236, right? The height of the peak is directly proportional to the concentration basically. It's a relative fluorescence unit what we are looking at. This is the height and this is the height. So if you see it's 3.8 RFU, this is 2.8 RFU. What is the conversion factor? You don't have to break your head. The machine will give you the detail. It's 2.99 nanogram per microliter and it's 4.74 nanogram per microliter. If you are running a cocktail of primer, you are expecting 5 different products out of the particular PCR. You will get concentration information of individual peaks. So you can kind of do a gene expression study right with this data. You don't have to actually go for your real time. To be honest, yes. But of course you need to have it because it's a relative quantification. People will ask for your real time PCR data. But this gives you an indication what it is. These are just supporting files, you know, we just diluted it 7 times and it just goes. That's okay. Just to sell. Alright. Application data, which is important. So when we say it is 3 base pair resolution, look at this guy. Your P1 and P2 heterogeneous, right? And your P1 and P2 heterogeneous, right? So look at the size difference between the red one circle. It's 96 base pair and 99 base pair. You're seeing two individual bands for 96 as well 99. And the blue one is 441 and 444. Two individual lines. So it's two individual peaks. You can discriminate in the gel level, not on a peak. On a gel level, you can discriminate. You have a question, sir? You have a question?
No.
Alright, okay. So that is how your data will come. Right? So the machine is capable of resolving your sample 3 to 5 base pairs. Right? So I just wanted to show you how a normal slab gel data looks and how your actual QIAxcel data looks. Look at the cleanliness and neatness and the sharpness of the pack. And you set up a 10 microliter reaction, I'll take 0.2 microliter out of it. You don't even feel that I've taken something. The entire 10 microliter is untouched. You can take it back for your downstream calculation. If you want it to use for something else, you're free to use. Alright, so pretty much done with the presentation. I just go to the comparison now.